Wszystkim bardzo serdecznie na moim kanale. Dzisiaj jesteśmy w Londynie przy stacji Victoria Station, żeby zobaczyć, co tutaj będzie się działo. Jest to marsz patriotyczny wszystkich tych, którzy cenią swoją wolność i wolność swoich rodzin i bezpieczeństwo swoich rodzin. Przemarsz zacznie tutaj chyba od godziny pierwszej, jest już godzina 11. To jest tak jakby oficjalne zaczęcie jest tego spotkania. Jest bardzo dużo ludzi, chociaż tutaj jest bardzo mało miejsca. Ciekawe, bo nie zamknęli tutaj żadnych ulic. Tym samym jest troszkę bardzo ciasno, bym powiedział. Tak, ciasno jest na pewno. Już nie chodzi mi o samych tutaj ludzi, którzy przyszli, tylko o tych, którzy właśnie przejeżdżają po prostu, nie? Bo ta stacja, ona cały czas działa. Więc pewnie będą jakieś opóźnienia, niestety, w ruchu. W każdym razie, to nie jest najważniejsze. Tommy Robinson jest obecnie przetrzymywany przez brytyjski rząd i z tego, co wiemy, pójdzie do więzienia na około 4 lata. Na 4 lata. W tym samym czasie, dosyć niedawno, został, ja uważam, że zabity przez angielski rząd Peter Lynch. To jest 61-latek, który po prostu protestował. Był tutaj na proteście, na poprzednich protestach, jak my tutaj dzisiaj jesteśmy. I przez to była łapanka zrobiona. Chcieli kogoś wsadzić, wsadzili go, no i popełnił samobójstwo w więzieniu, tak? No, ja uważam, że to nie było samobójstwo, tylko że rząd angielski do czego się przyczynił. Jak wiemy, jest Tutier Kern, oni tutaj robią co chcą i dają wyroki tylko tym, którzy się przeciwstawiają tyranii rządu. Dobrze, już nie będę na siebie kamery dawał, tylko zaczniemy już filmować protest.
I see. What happened to him is just scandalous.
Okej, z tego co wychodzi, to już policja zaczyna ludzi prosić o zacięcie przemarszu. Dobra, to będziemy powoli, powoli iść.
All right, Rocky, shouldn't we all join on?
Yeah.
You're looking for me all the time.
Yeah, aren't you? With that silly hat you got on, I can't miss him.
That's why you aim it up, right?
That's the way it is in court. You've got to put your hand on the Bible. When you get married, you're going to church. When you have a funeral, you're going to church. Don't let them take away the foundation of England, man.
Yes, Dad.
Amen.
Bless you.
We call Jesus, not Allah. We call Jesus. We call Jesus over here. Believe or not.
Hello, we love you. Ten pan, dla tych, którzy nie wiedzą, on prowadzi kanał w serwisie YouTube. I właśnie on jest takim, ma bardzo patriotyczny kanał i jego treści zawsze odkrywają jakieś powiedzmy złe uczynki rządzących, tak to powiedzieć można w skrócie. Bardzo miło widzieć go tutaj. Myślałem, że może on gdzieś będzie tam bardziej z frontu, a on tutaj sobie po prostu blogował. No i zajebiście. Okej, okay, właśnie zauważyłem innego pana, który ostatnio był w Polsce. Może go poznajecie. To jest amerykański bloger. Cieszę się, że on tutaj jest, bo on ma bardzo duże zasięgi.
Thank you.
Tutaj jakiś robotnik wspiera nas. Znaczy, myślę, że wszyscy wspierają, ale ten akurat ma flagę. Thank you.
feels like it shouldn't be there.
Tommy,
powiem wam, że jest bardzo dużo ludzi dzisiaj. Podobna sytuacja była poprzednim razem, gdzie na początku było ich troszkę mniej, a później w trakcie dochodziło więcej i więcej, a już wtedy na Trafalgar Square już było nas od groma. Dzisiaj widzę, że nie jest gorzej. Już teraz nie jest gorzej, a jeszcze nie dotarliśmy do naszego końcowego punktu. Jak widzimy, znowu musieliśmy się na chwilę zatrzymać. Prawdopodobnie ze względów bezpieczeństwa musieli poczekać, żeby zabezpieczyć następne odcinki. Zgaduję na tym, że to, co za nami już jest, to już na pewno te ulice pootwierali. Ale jest morze flag, morze rąk i morze ludzi. Widzę nawet flagi amerykańskie. Widzę również zdjęcie Donalda Trumpa. No, to nie dziwne, że tutaj ludzie wspierają Donalda Trumpa, bo jest to osoba, która może zapobiec wielu nieszczęściom na całym świecie, nie tylko w Stanach Zjednoczonych. Okej, więc nasz marsz ruszył dalej. Byliśmy tutaj troszkę przetrzymani. Prawie do godziny pierwszej, bo to takie oficjalne wyjście z tego, co słyszałem od innych osób, było o godzinie pierwszej. A wcześniej to po prostu był czas na zebranie sił. I powiem wam, że jest strasznie, ale to strasznie dużo ludzi. Jest pięknie. Wiele patriotów, wiele osób z różnych kręgów kulturowych i wszyscy wspierają dzisiejszy protest. Jeśli chodzi o ilość ludzi, to końca nie widać. Jest przynajmniej, moim zdaniem, drugie tyle, co poprzednim razem. Z tego, co wtedy byłem zszokowany. Dzisiaj jest tych ludzi naprawdę dużo. Ostatnio było około, nie wiem, czy teraz nie pamiętam, nie będę kłamał, wiele tysięcy. Są różne telewizje, pewnie propagandowe.
Hey, you're gonna face it.
Thank you.
Ok, jesteśmy już blisko punktu naszego docelowego. Widać już, jest scenę. Jesteśmy pod parlamentem. Widać tu nasz wieżę z zegarem Big Ben. I tutaj odbędzie się główna część naszego spotkania dzisiejszego, naszego protestu, naszej celebracji. Rozmawiałem z kilkoma osobami tak w międzyczasie. Naprawdę, wszyscy tutaj są bardzo przyjemni, jest bardzo spokojnie. Nikt nie ma problemów, nawet papierka na ziemię nie rzucają. Jesteśmy tu, jest bardzo dużo ludzi. Postaram się znaleźć jakieś fajne miejsce, ale dzisiaj nie będę filmował całego filmu, który... Poprzednio wyświetlili film dokumentalny. Dzisiaj będzie prawdopodobnie tak samo, tylko że inny film dokumentalny na temat korupcji i tyranii rządu. Ale nie będę tego całego filmował, bo na platformach typu X na pewno to będzie, więc nie ma sensu, żebym ja to filmował. Ja możecie sobie obejrzeć po prostu to w lepszej jakości. Po prostu pod moim filmem postaram się dać ewentualnie link. Albo sobie wyszukacie sami, albo pójdziecie z linka. Excuse me? Sorry, excuse me? Oh, sorry, mate. Excuse me? Postaram się może pójść tam, gdzie jest troszkę więcej miejsca. O, jest. I tam jest ekran jeden, i tu jest drugi ekran, więc jest naprawdę bardzo dużo ludzi. Aż ciężko. No nie widać końca, zwłaszcza jak tutaj niżej jest ten troszkę. Ale postaram się później ładnie jakiś kadr dla was zrobić.
Light us in the water.
Nie wiem, czy widzicie, ale jest obraz Matki Boskiej. Jest dużo osób, którzy chodzą z flagami Jezusa o Jezusie Chrystusie mówiącymi. It's not for glory, this train. Sing it together. This train is uniting the kingdom of Israel. Come on, you can do it now. This train is uniting the kingdom of Israel. You better get on board. This train is uniting the kingdom of England, Scotland.
It's not love. It's not love. You chose with a robot.
Because there's a percentage of people that you're injecting
that you could actually be causing serious harm to. Do you not, does that not process in your mind?
I have eyewitnesses who saw you taking envelopes of money off of Pakistani gangsters.
It's a deliberate attempt to cover up these crimes against little girls for fear of being called racist. There are five dead females in the hands of these gangs.
They've had nominal protests saying then they're shipped to hotels up and down this country. And we've seen some of them living in five-star hotels, some of them are living in bed and breakfast.
Do you rate about farming in last like?
You have lied, you have played your part, and all of you who call yourself journalists, you all know what was happening to those girls in all of those towns and cities, and you've got nothing, you said nothing.
Just making
what were you doing with hanging around with 13 old school children?
As you can see, these people here are trying to do all they can to stop the British people to see what's going on behind these doors. The threat to national security does not come from citizen journalists, reporters on this stuff. The threat to national security comes very, very simply from the people in government and the people that are making masses amount of money bringing illegal migrants into this country and processing them.
They are punishing the people who speak out in defence of the children of the poor.
There is fucking nothing that compares to rape. The only thing that compares to rape. Torture.
You're not going to have the BBC News doing this, you're not going to have ITV, GB, anyone. This is real citizen journalism.
Of course he does, but I also know
Labor doesn't want anybody to feel sad because you made the decision to air the documentary and it doesn't require at the Hooters. But what you also want is for everybody to play the game today and do it right. And when we leave at the end of a beautiful day we've got lined up, it really is glorious. It's going to be full of love and good energy. So we're still going to have a good time, yes? Yeah. And then when we disperse, we've got to do it in mind that there are going to be people that are envious of us because we are all together as one. Yeah. And they will try and prod you and provoke you and they want a reaction from you. Don't give them what they want. Do not let the mainstream media report lies or one little misdemeanor tomorrow. So all this goes to waste. Look how fucking lovely it is! I'm going to be back and forth. If you can be kind to me, I'll try and be kind to you. But no pressure. But somebody did ask me if I end up in jail. You step in and host the event. So I'm here as a friend to Tommy, to the team, to the country, and every single one of you. Thank you for the last step to help and hand you over to a personal friend of mine and yours, Mr. Paul Thorpe and Hammer.
Well, I thought I don't know where to start. I can set it up. Guys, first of all, thank you so much for coming today as the MC. It is a celebration of no tinge of sadness. When I was growing up, I was taught that song about the greatest leader this country was ever blessed to have. It's the Churchill. That's the song. That generation was lucky to have a leader. But today we are also blessed, this generation is also blessed to have a man who stays tall, who stays proud, who stays in the Britain. His name's not Winston Churchill, his name is Tommy Robinson.
Well,
make no mistake, never be in doubt, doesn't matter what anyone says, you can go home tonight, put your head on a pillar. Rest assured that you have been here today for the right reasons. Never let anyone sway you from that. And our job is now to awaken our friends, our families, our neighbours. And I want to finish by paying a tribute to Peter Lynch. We would have been here today if it hadn't been. Join me now in the minute support, not only for our Tommy, but for our Peter Lynch. God bless his soul, God bless him. Peter and your family, we are here for you. So this week, everyone, I'm going to be upset. I don't give them any reason to doubt.
Thank you, Paul. You're an absolute gentleman. I'm sure everybody here will agree. And it's now, as I said before, we're here for a good time today. So when Tommy's sitting in his cell, he knows none of this went to waste. And let me introduce the next speaker. Andrew Bridgen, it's all yours, brother.
Remember the 5th of November, gunpowder, treason, and heart. I see no reason why gunpowder and treason should ever be forgotten. It's going to be a big event of world significance on the 5th of November in America. This will affect the whole world, and I ask you to pray for the right result. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm so proud of you all. I'm proud to be here. But we're all saddened at those who are missing. and our prayers and thoughts should be with Tommy Robinson and family and friends of Peter Lynch. There's something that is a demonstration of the talking that we're living under at the moment. We know that Tommy's not a terrorist, and we know that Peter was never a rioter. They can take 1,000 of us, and 10,000 will stand up to take their place. And you will all take comfort that the worst things appear to get are nearer we are to the end. We're in a dark tunnel, but we're nearer to the light than we are to the beginning, and we must press forward together. The worldwide attack on freedom and liberty we've seen over the last few years cannot succeed because too many people around the world have woken up. We see what you do, and we will not let it happen. In life, we tend to get what we're willing to tolerate. Well, the world, the good people, freedom-loving people, will tolerate this no longer. I've often been asked. Why do I wear a paperclip on my lapel? Well, 2 years ago I spoke at a conference in Norway. And in Norway they call them binders, they bind people together. And they told me they invented the paperclip just before the Second World War. And during the German, the Nazi occupation of Norway, the Norwegians wore the paperclip as a sign of resistance to occupation. It was punishable by summary execution by firing squad, but still the brave Norwegians resisted. They said they had no one in Norway to speak in their parliament, and would I wear the binder when I spoke in our parliament and speak for them as well. The paperclip is a sign of opposing international oppression, and I'm proud to wear it for you and for the Norwegians. All freedom-loving people of the world are watching us today. They're expecting us to take a lead. As has already been said, we must be peaceful. There's a right-wing protest, and they've got a right-wing protest as well. What it demonstrates to me is the failures of our schools and our universities, because it's clear to me that our schools and our universities are not teaching our young people to think. They're telling them what to think, and that is very damaging. The main weapon that our oppressors use against us is fear. And once we learn to live without fear, there's nothing they can do to them. There's nothing they can do to Tommy, and sadly there's nothing now that they can do to Peter. We have to live without fear. People think that we have no power, we're just individuals, we're just drops in the ocean. But we're not. We're all linked. We're all connected. We are all the ocean in a drop. Enjoy the day and have a great time. Thank you for listening to me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now, what we need to divide us. Put us in a state of submission by fear, and they don't know the truth. They try their best to divide us and take a little look around. Do we feel divided today? Yeah, do we bollocks? Have a little look. Now, talking of media, the new media, the real honest media that tells you exactly what's going on without prejudice. The opposite side to the lying BBC Sky News film. The next one on the stage, the next man, is Mr. Mayor Susie. Come on!
Apparently this life is a taboo. It's a sin to hold on here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's not forget We're here for the kingdom. We're also joined by patriots from around the world. We got all the usual flags, the American flags, the Israeli, we also have the French flag. Even the bloody Welsh are here. The Iranian flag. But we're here, not just the United Kingdom. We think about Peter Lynch, Rhiannon Sky White, a hotel worker who lost her life yesterday after an attack by the illegal migrants of Sudan. We think of Tommy Robinson in jail right now. We think about the three little innocent girls of Southport who lost their life. Now, the building right behind me, down the street, and the one over there, the House of Parliament, they think we are far-right anarchists. Just because we criticize the system. We criticize the system because we want it to be better. I am going to talk about the political side. But the fact that they are scared of you guys are far right, unless they are scared and terrified of far right grandmothers and all the families and children, and again people coming from France and Canada and Australia. My mother apparently is also far right club. She was slain by the British Embassy from Iran. She was an actual political refugee. She came in to give me a fresh chance in life. To what end? I now have to have private security because I get death threats. We're doing my job. We're doing a job that the BBC should be doing. We're simply reporting the news. Now, this wasn't what my mum actually wanted. I will be safer in Gaza than in London at this point. Now, I have a message to the political establishment, the main three political parties. First one, Reform UK. Our friends at Reform, this crowd is not what you think. You misunderstood them. Look around, bring your representatives, talk to the crowd here. Don't be scared. These people, a lot of them voted for you. My message to the Tories. People are here protesting against Keir Starmer, but let's not forget, this crowd was not created by the Labour government. This was happening under the Tories. You created this. It's your fault. Finally, what is my message to the Labour government? Nothing positive. The only message is actually to you guys when it comes to the Labour government. Get ready. Campaign. Fight. Don't give up. Unite the right. Unite the kingdom. Stop the division. Fight. 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 Final message to all the other patriots who come here to support the British public, the Americans, the Israelis, the French. Thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your support. We will support you in your fight and your countries. Nationalists and patriots, it's time to unite. We've been too isolated. We've been left each other alone. It's time to support each other. Thank you very much. I'm high to see and me, all the media. The next man, I'm going to refer to him as a man. His father fact is he's 13 years of age. He's just about to get up on stage and speak in front of you lovely people. And there's lots of you. If you can see what I'm seeing, the crowds go back and back and back. And we have a young, up-and-coming politician who gets stick, but still labeled the stigma, far right, the usual tripe. It'll be nice actually to get something, because you can see that there's nothing far right about this crowd. The only thing is, it's just right. So please, give this young man a massive cheer, a round of applause. I don't know anybody his age to come and do this. What a man! Let's go! Charlie Dickinson! United as one. We call us far right because we love our country. And every one of you are not far right, you're concerned citizens.
because down at Downing Street, Keir Starmer protects his owner. Not you. Keir Starmer has blood on his hands. We stand here united. He killed Peter Lynch. This government did. Now, I ask you all of one to join us in the fight for freedom, to bring our country back. Great Britain, make it truly great. Now, I can see a UKIP flag. UKIP and the real party. The party for the people, not Reform UK. Fake party, fake, fake, fake. You kicked me out because I love good Tommy. Are you all hearing this? The party for the patriots. Tommy's the biggest patriot we've ever got. So, I ask you all, at the next election, you're voting for UKIP, you join UKIP. Right, I'm going to start finishing off now, but thank you. And remember, keep doing your country proud.
You are a living legend. Oh man, join him, come on! Give him some! Unbelievable! Wow! Respect to you, brother. Get a picture. Get a picture. Yeah, well, you know what? Credit where credit's due. Credit where credit is due. Go on, lift up the top. Just to compound on Charlie Simpson, what he said and what he just done there, and giving people credit where it's due. This is what we need more of. Giving people credit when they're due, building each other up, being each other's brother and sister and friend, and encouraging each other to do the right thing all the time. Now I'm going to pass you over to Lux and Vicky. So forgive me, I have been parachuted in to do this. And then, from Lutz and Vicky, we are going to get Richard Inman on straight after, and then he is going to show you Tommy's documentary. So I'll be back in a little while. Until then, have a glorious time!
Not allowed to be in Germany anymore because I'm fighting for freedom of speech. I expose the hypocrites in Germany, the politics, and today we are all here for Tommy because he's a political prisoner for showing the world what's really going on in all over Europe, because this is not only happening in the UK, it's everywhere. It's in Brazil. I'm doing a documentary for Urban Scoop about what's going on in Brazil. And we have to stand together. Today is a very important day for the whole world. You make a sign, you stand up, and the world has to watch you and has to follow you in the fight for freedom of speech for our children. Because our children have a right to live in freedom and have a right to grow up in a country to be proud of. You have to be proud to be British. I have a proud, a right to be proud to be German. They can't take that away from us! Don't let them take that away from us! But today, we are all Peter Lynch and Free Tommy. I want that you put in every post on Twitter, Free Tommy, hashtag Free Tommy. Flood the internet with this hashtag, that the world sees what's going on, because mainstream media doesn't want that to be seen. And we don't care anymore. We are the people. We are fighting for our rights. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Richard name is Lutz. I'm the founder of the Beginner Movement in Germany. And I met Tommy 10 years ago, and since then we became friends, and we're actually going the same way. I'm facing the same charges. I'm still free, I'm the lucky one, but I'm facing the next one in a couple of months, so I'm not sure that I'm going to join you that soon again. But we have to stand together everywhere, all patriots all over the world. We have to go our way, we have to fight for the freedom of speech. Tommy's been charged with it, I'm charged with it. So that's why, support Tommy and support every people's movement in this world, which is going to fight for the freedom of speech, which is a people's right. This is the most important thing. If they take away that from us, we are at the end. That's it from me and Free Tommy. Let's call it again as Liam did before. Oh, Tommy, Tommy! Tommy, 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 Tommy Robinson! Thanks! Thank you, London. Thank you, Great Britain.
And fight, fight, fight!
One more thing that we're all going to have to play a little. Charlie Healy from X Factor is due to be singing on stage and is in the crowd and he's struggling to get through. Which is a great thing because it shows how many people have turned up, but we need to figure out a way of getting him through, you lot. So, Charlie, if you can hear me, just tap whoever's in front of you on the shoulder and say, I'm Charlie Healy. So if somebody taps her on the shoulder saying they're Charlie Healy, get him to the stage, the man's got to see! And now over to Mr. Richard Gibbon, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, what Liam just said there reminded me of an old film called Spartacus. So we don't want everyone coming to the platform saying, I am Charlie Healy. We only want a real Charlie Healy. But if you remember that film, Spartacus, what was the catchphrase from Spartacus? I am Spartacus. Every single one of you in this crowd today, I want to hear your voices saying, I am Tommy Robinson! I am Tommy Robinson!
Oh, yes! Tommy Robinson!
And he's not a hero! And he's not here today! And he won't be at any more demonstrations, and we've seen the videos of him! One of us, just an ordinary man, a grandfather just like I am, a father just like I am, and a patriot just like I am. Peter Lynch should be here today, and he's not. Let's have a massive cheer for Peter Lynch. And before I forget, what we're going to do when the film's on, we're going to pass buckets around the audience and we're going to do a collection for Peter Lynch's family. And we're going to do a collection for Tommy Robinson's children. If I didn't say it now, I would have forgotten. But we're here. We're here because we're at a very pivotal moment in our country. And I believe every single one of us is not just a Peter Lynch and a Tommy Robinson. Every single person in this crowd is a British hero. You are all British heroes! And there are many times we come here and we talk about the problems and we talk about what's wrong, and you're going to see a film in a minute that goes into great detail about that. But I want to say something. Every single person in this crowd is not a problem. You are the solution, and you're the people that are going to take our country back. And my message, to Keir Starmer, the person who hates grandfathers. What do we think of Keir Starmer? What do we think of Keir Starmer? I agree. I'm not
the same way I think that Keir Starmer could have been told to keep it clean. Keir Starmer has to go. Keir Starmer will go. And in 5 years' time, we're going to send him packing. And hopefully, we'll send him to prison as well. What are we going to do now? We're going to show a film. And this film talks about Peter Lynch. This film talks about the heroes, the political prisoners that have been locked up for nothing. Our judicial system has been weaponized by evil people in that house behind you. It's got to change. It's got to change. This film is going to tell the story of Peter Lynch. It's going to tell the story of Tommy Robinson. But it's going to tell the story of hundreds of other people whose lives and families have been destroyed by those corrupt people in that house behind you. And before we start the film, I want everyone in this crowd, I want us to observe a 1 minute silence. So I'm going to ask you, when I stop talking, when I shut my big mouth in about 30 seconds, I want a hush to go over this crowd. I'm going to ask Liam if you could time me to make sure we get 1 minute. When I stop talking, I want this entire crowd to go silent for the hero of our age, Peter Lynch. Men sitting in jail, right now, they know that. And this government will be held to account more quickly than they expect. The tyranny we are seeing now, it's been years in the making. Blair, Cameron, May, Johnson, Sunak, and now Starmer. They're all subjects of the World Economic Masters and its totalitarian agenda. Years and years of small steps, controlling your speech, importing help, taking your freedoms. So, the hour is upon us. The time is now. Each one of us must take a stand. We must build communities of resistance. We must organise politically. Conservative, Labour, Lib Dems. We must drive every globalist from power. We must reclaim our nation.
This is a very urgent business, ladies and gentlemen, I beseech you. Resist it while you still can, and before the right to complain is taken away from you, which will be the next thing. You will be told you can't complain. Watch out for these symptoms. They are symptoms of surrender. Resist it while you can.
We must resist while we still can.
You stand there preaching, taking us for fools. One more boat wash up, you focus on winter fuel. The art of distraction from the issue at hand. A foreign invasion of our ancestral lands. They are no refugees. They are no fleeing from war. Most of them are fighting age men. What do you think they're coming here for? Shame on you! Shame on you! When I fall, I shame on you. Tell the truth! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Paid for by Lord Ali. While you take the side of every minority, you brand the British people indigenous to this land. As far right racist thoughts, why can't you understand? They are no refugees. They are no fleeing from war. Most of them are fighting age men. What do you think they're coming here for? Shame on you! Shame on you! We're not far right, shame on you. Tell the truth! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you! Shame on you!
What did you think of that? Well, let's get some energy back in this house. Are we going to make sure our women and children are safe? Are we going to let the tyrannical government silence us? And are we going to let the mainstream media divide us? Absolutely not. Ladies and gents, Ezra Levant.
It's great to see everybody. If I had to sum up British law in two words, it would be the Latin phrase sare decisis, which means let the precedent stand. Another way of saying that is, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. Another way of saying that is, you have to have one standard of justice, not two standards of justice. And what I've seen in the United Kingdom, it's not the UK I heard about who lost to Canada. When we studied the law, when we looked at the roots of it, the rule of law, we looked at the British cases, and it meant that no one was above the law. No one was too powerful or too fancy to be held to account, but it also meant no one was beneath the law. And I believe that second part is a problem in the United Kingdom today. Look at the treatment of thousands of young girls in this country, like in Rotherham. They were beneath the law didn't give a damn about them, because they were indigenous, white, British women, and that's just completely incorrect. Look at how this event is being policed today. Riot police, with their riot gear. I saw one cop filming the other one's face, he's holding me with I was in London for the 100,000 person pro-Hamas march, where they chanted for Intifada, that the violent riot against the Jews, where they called for genocide. No riot police survived there. No one filmed the faces there. I'm worried that the United Kingdom's core character of the rule of law is falling apart. And the fact that they are trying to intimidate you and not have you gather is part of that. Tony Robbins was arrested last night under the Terrorism Act, a version of the American Patriot Act, because he wouldn't give them the cell phone password to get into the phone. That's a law for terrorists, not for journalists. You think they apply that law to the organizers of the pro-Hamas rallies in this city week after week? They did not. The police were not even visible in those rallies. They were taken away by the events. I think it's incredibly important that you stand up here, not just for Tom Robinson, and not just for yourselves, but for the great legacy that you have inherited from generations that came before you. So many lives were lost over so many centuries to keep we're in the legal system that everyone would trust and love. And look at the rules going on that before I give you a look at that. There are some people who would drive Tommy Robinson out of the mainstream, out of the mainstream, who would ban him from having rallies. But Tommy Robinson's mind is necessary to keep hundreds of thousands, maybe millions of people involved in the system.
If Jesus is kept out, people will give up on the system. They'll give up on the freedom. Keep fighting for freedom. Keep fighting for freedom. In the name of God.
Here's something you might be interested in. So, behind the scenes, Urban Scoop have been talking to Tommy today from jail. And what Tommy said is that in the next 2 to 3 weeks, be prepared for a peaceful protest outside whatever jail he's in, which will probably be Belfast.
Good afternoon, everybody. Can I cause chaos for a couple of moments? Given the significance of today, I want you to look to a person to your left or to your right, or in front or behind, and get their attention and say, "My name is," and give them your name. "And I am from," and tell them where you're from, and make a statement to them. It is good to stand with you today. Would you do that? Next 30 seconds, just very quickly. Make sure you speak to somebody.
I'm Zimmy, I'm from Poland. It's lovely to stand with you today.
I'm Vicky from the Ulta Kids. It's lovely to stand with you today.
What's yourself?
Okay, so congratulations, everybody should at least have one new friend that they can stand with. And by the end of these 2 words, I hope that I too am your friend. And so can I ask you to work with me for the next few moments. Today is a wonderful event. It's for the good people of this fair and blessed land to meet, to say that we love our nation. And that is why we are here. We can do better than that. We love our nation. However, what is to be done to this nation by those we have entrusted in power? And the actions of yesterday have only sought to galvanize people's feelings. The reason why I am here today, and there's one reason, and that is because you are here. That's the reason I'm here, it's because you are here. There are all kinds of people all over this gathering this afternoon who are hurting, who are frustrated, who are angry, who are confused, who feel let down. And in the case of the family of Peter Lynch and others, are bereaved. It was always the way in times past that when people were hurting, that they were frustrated or angry or confused or let down or bereaved or in need of help, that they would seek out a cleric. And that is why I'm here today. I'm here for every single one of you. And that's why I accepted the invite. I'm here for those like Peter, whose lives have been ripped from us prematurely. And so many of the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
As a priest in God's church, I feel I need to do a couple of things before I hand the microphone back. I feel firstly that it is necessary for me to apologize to you for what the church has often done to you and how the church has let you down. And for that, I am sorry. I need to apologize for the church's involvement in scandals, where evil people, like in other institutions, have been able to infiltrate her ranks. The church should have been better, and I am sorry. The church is meant to be the hands and feet of Jesus. I am therefore sorry for where the church has failed to and not stood up for the nation and spoken to the nation in the way that we have deserved. I'm sorry that the church has not protected the heritage of this nation and instead has gone after other agendas instead of the message of Jesus. And it's caused division. And it's caused hurt. And it's meant the church has not been with the people. It has not called out hypocrisy or wrong. It has not warned of the perils of turning away from the principles that this nation was founded on Judeo-Christian Christian values.
Oh, yeah!
It is 2024. That's 2024 years since the birth of Christ. It's 7 days because on the seventh day God rested. And 7 days is the only cycle of words. A few meters away in the Houses of Parliament, in the central lobby, there is an inscription on the floor. And it says, unless the Lord builds the house, those that labor do so in vain. And so I just want to say today, if you are a country Christian, hold to those values. Better still be inspired to find the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is weeping over this nation now. My name is Tanner Phil Harris. I'm from Old Hill in West Midlands, and it's been good to stand with you, every single one of you, today. Thank you. He's going to be a treat when he makes some fantastic music. Let's hear it from Ross and Long. He's going to sing a song called Save Me.
Look at you. You get to hear twice in one day. The huge box of them don't come in over the side. You must be tired of being with his daughter, it's crazy. All that we want is our mother's clothes. But all that we got is you and your love. You just need some time, spend it out for a while. I can't stop there, but I love you, so for my love, but when it's over, thinking it's easy, and you love me, 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 you love. I try to see the dark turn, but my time is waiting.
I'm not being funny. Cause we're on the king. Our women inside. Just been out on those shit. Just don't give me the money. That's all my passion. But I guess you'd rather make friends like Jimmy and Phil over in Poland. Maybe it's Greece. They don't love you. They'll be a rich girl.
Free Tommy Robinson. Thank you very much.
And a friend of Tommy Robinson. There's a lot more to Danny Lockwood than that. A big massive round of applause for Danny Lockwood. Hello, London. Wow. It is enough for me, Yorkshire Brothers, to get down this road. A couple of things. Firstly, I'm following a priest, and I should admit that I am a sinner, because I am Danny Lockwood, and a journalist. And more than that, for over 40 years, I've been a member of the mainstream media. A little bit louder, please. Heck, I even write on the BBC! I also have been a colleague of Tommy Robinson for 10 years. I worked with Tommy on two of his books, Enemy of the State and Silenced. As an editor, I was once the director of the United Kingdom Society of Editors. I have been in front of judges for contempt and libel even more than Tommy. As such, it puts me in a good position to explain to you today what I believe he's just been put through. And I would not have been here today if Tommy had not been dragged off the streets and locked up yesterday. In my 46 years as a journalist, I've seen some grievous and egregious injustices carried out, but never have I seen two worse than the ones I'm just going to outline for you very briefly. In 2018, Tommy was dragged off the streets of Leeds by a judge called Geoffrey Marison. He was locked up for weeks on end on a contempt of court charge that I can tell you now was not contempt of court. Indeed, if you remember the case, it was thrown out and Tommy was free. Such was the state of the British establishment that the Attorney General was instructed to go back and find something to get Tommy Robinson back on court on, and they did. I sat in the Old Bailey in 2019 and I watched Dame Victoria Sharp tear up the 1981 Contempt of Court Act and rewrite it specifically to put our friend in jail. That was unheralded in the history of my 46 years as a journalist and an editor. I thought it couldn't get worse than that, but it did. In 2021, you remember that Tommy was in court for libel. He was bankrupt, he didn't have a lawyer. The judge in that case, Sir Matthew Nicklin, appointed me as what is called a Mackenzie friend. I sat by Tommy's side through that entire trial, hoping to prepare his case, his defence, all the court documentation. And I thought I'd seen it all at the Old Bailey when they locked Tommy up. I hadn't seen it all. In that 2 week trial, a young man from Huddersfield came on the first morning, gave a sulky 40 minutes of evidence and then disappeared for the rest of the trial. He did not face his accusers. That court, Sir Matthew Nicklin, heard from parents, teachers, a head teacher, social workers, Berkeley's Council documentation about the character of that young man, Jamal Hijazi. At the end of it, five young people from Huddersfield came and gave evidence. Five courageous young people. And after 3 months, Justice Matthew Nicklin was prepared to call us all back into court for his verdict. But he didn't.
Well, not that was, excuse me. And the reason he didn't was because he was ashamed to face those children. And he found Tommy Robinson guilty, and he said, of each one of those five children and those seven teachers and parents, that every single one of them lied. That's on the record, it's in the public record. He called every one of them a liar. And when he justified it in finding Tommy guilty, he said this. Why do people lie? Who knows? People sometimes just lie. And with that, it destroyed Tommy's livelihood, it destroyed my faith in British justice, and he committed what, to me, was the biggest single injustice I've ever witnessed in my 46 years as a journalist. Tommy Robinson is a good man. I'm an ordinary journalist. Tommy Robinson, I can tell you, is an extraordinary journalist. A good man and a good patriot, and for one mainstream media journalist, I salute you, Tommy. Thank you very much.
Of the Southport riots. The very first day, far right. The next day, racists. What are those words? What do they mean? These are exclusionary words. These are words designed to put you into the second category, to show that you do not enjoy the same rights as everyone else. That's what they are for. So what kind of country does this create? Well, an oppressive one, an unfair one, but also a decaying one, a third world one, where politicians take their gifts and their bribes while the rest of the people are impoverished. The creeping socialist government that began under Tony Blair is finally its final realization over Keir Starmer. For the first time since the Black Death, England is becoming poorer. We are being slowly but surely immiserated by design. If democracy can be defined as people getting what they voted for, then we haven't had a democracy for quite some time. We've been voting against mass immigration for decades. We have been voting against tax increases for decades. We have been voting against the increase of the administrative state for decades. And yet, now we are saddled with the most unpopular Labour government in history that intends to increase all of these things. They're going to continue the agenda of mass immigration. But what problem does that solve? What is solved by the overpopulation of Britain? We have now 15 million more people than when this began. Do we feel that we have fewer or more problems at this point? They're going to continue to raise our taxes. I don't know about you, but I'm dreading the next budget. When does this end? When will it ever be enough? There is a black hole that will never fill because they are trying to provide national services on an international scale. It can never end. We do not have enough money. And they are going to continue trying to micromanage every aspect of our lives. When did we ever consent to this? Ladies and gentlemen, I will leave you with this story. All of these parties basically agree with the same agenda. We have to use our vote. The power of selection is still with us. We must choose different parties. We must have it in our minds that it is unthinkable, unthinkable ever to vote for a blue, red, or yellow rosette ever again. And I'm sure I don't need to mention the Greens or the Monarch. You know. This is the only way out of this. We must commit to parties that are for the people rather than for some external value. Because they will turn that, as they are doing with the NHS, into an idol that will be molded over you and you will be constricted into its maintenance.
when we were set up to serve you. Thank you very much.
Just look at the screen, what do you see on the screen? Years ago, the Beatles played massive stadiums, women came forward, and dare I say, threw their knickers at the stage. Well, there's a pair of knickers in moments that sums up the Labour Party. Labour are pants! This friend of mine, he's come all the way from the United States of America. He's Tommy Robinson's best friend in the United States of America. He's an absolute legend. He's a massive Trump supporter. He's a fantastic speaker. Get him out of the Woo!
Those of you who don't know who my name is, Don Keith, and I gotta tell you, if Keir Starmer thought he was gonna put a damper on this event by putting England's greatest voice in lockup, he had another thing coming. Everybody say, Keir Starmer can kiss my ass!
Yeah!
So I've told this story a couple of times, but I wanna say it because I've never said it to 100,000 people before. You know, great heroes come along maybe once in a generation, if you're lucky. You got your Winston Churchills, you got your William Wallace's in the United States. We have people like Martin Luther King. You know, they don't come around a lot. Now, in America, we have one this generation. We got lucky. We have a guy named Donald Trump. Maybe you heard his name before. But then you got another guy that we call the working class Donald Trump of Great Britain, and his name is Tommy Robbins. So the way I see it, you know, I see a lot of people say they're like, can't wait to get out of here. I'm gonna go to America, I'm gonna go somewhere else. We all have to stay and fight for our countries. Because if we go at some point, there's really nothing we want to run to. So we have a choice to make. You guys have a choice to make. Years from now, generations from now, you can sit around a fire, scrap up a little bit of food, you can find, and you can reminisce with your grandchildren about what a great free country Great Britain used to be. Or you can tell them that today England is still free because you fought with people like Tommy Robinson and the great patriots that are here today. Now, I've got something I want to read to you. Tommy asked me to read this to you guys, and I was with him yesterday. I felt honored to be one of the ones he asked to escort him to the police station yesterday. But he asked me to read this, and I'm not going to let him down. It's a poem I wrote, and I wrote it as it pertains to America, but it could go to any Western country right now. You can apply it to yourselves. I guess I'd like to ask you guys, how many of you have ever been online or even out in public and someone called you a racist or a white supremacist simply because you espouse your personal conservative beliefs? Show of hands, who's ever been called a racist on social media? Yeah, love you now. There's a lot of this for you guys. I hope you enjoy this poem. It's a poem. It's called The Liberty Key. If I were a racist, I'd come up with a plan. I'd give them just enough money so they wouldn't need a man. The father rebukes, but the mother will miss him when all of her sons are raised by the system. And what would I call this act of piety? I know I'll call it the Great Society. No need for family. I'll take God out of school. You can worship the government just to obey all the rules. But to be a great racist, I need to find a way to decrease the numbers of black, brown, and, hey, abortion. But with a little more stealth, I'll fool the whole world and call it women's hell. But still, some will be born, so we'll need to confuse them. We can turn men into women and women into men. I think that'll do it. That'll do the trick, but still there will be others. We'll need to make them sick with food or drugs. Well, surely in time, we can also invest their memory of crime. And the people who love me, no matter what the fuss is, because I'll do all of these things and call up justice. Now, this plan will cost money. I'll impose more tax on the people who already break their backs. Who cares? They can nickel and dime it and get this outlet all on the climate. No more comfort, no more convenience, no more oil, no gasoline. It's going to be amazing. This is a hell of a plan. Why even worry about the color of a man? Black, white, gay, or straight? For total control, I need to stir up hate and divide every single person by their system beliefs. They might even call me the liberty thief, because I'll take all their freedoms and it'll be tough, I confess. How do I do it? I'll use the press. They've spread the word of propaganda for years, until one day a new virus appears. That's when the VCs really hits the fan base. Goes, I'll have forced vaccines and mass mandates. I can shut down schools and control elections. Start all about section by section. And poverty will replace the American dream while the oligarch siphons the war machine. But if I'm really going to do this, I mean, if I'm really going to own it, I need to get rid of my political opponent. I can twist the laws and accuse them of crimes. It shouldn't be too hard. I mean, the judges are mine. Not to mention the prosecution. This is how it's done, man. It's true, the Constitution. But for my masterpiece and my greatest inspiration, I will replace every patriot with illegal immigration. So that's it, that's how I'll do it. And with the competition gone, I'll be a shoe-in. So, a racist and a tyrant, well, don't call me that. I need to be discreet. Call me a Democrat. Thank you very much for having me. I love you guys. God bless you, Mr. Robinson.
If no one talks about the intelligence of women, then they will.
We talk about all forms of violence against women, regardless of the other. But we do not miss a recurring pattern in immigrant representation among these aggressors. We fight against the growing insecurity, judicial laxity, and against repressive and patriarchal cultures brought in France by immigration. Immigration is a big problem, and we are not afraid to say it. We do impactful actions to wake people up, and we make politicians take responsibility. Because of this, we are progressive, but when we speak the truth, and the facts show that we are right. Today, we are 150 activists in France, Belgium, and Switzerland, fighting for the truth of the world. Hello, my name is Yusuf Haider, I am 22 years old, and I am a full person for the Genesis Collective. I decided to take action because as a young woman in the city, where women and women face insecurity. About a year ago, you may have seen the latest Genesis program. It featured three different Christian women, women, and others at the top of the French line. But you may have also seen our response. Along with this trend, we created our own version. We posed like a token in the original program, but the women be blue, white and white dresses instead of other. I wore a dress that does a bit shorter to show the sense of freedom that the women always shall have provided to see you have. This was important to us because France is still in the country and French men are free.
Moms and dads, grandmas and grandpas, we need you. If tonight or never. I ask you to rise up and stop the dictator to the destruction of our people. Your daughter, your son, our civilization need. Join us. Together, let's raise our voices to defend the rights, safety, and freedom of the European woman. Let this woman cross borders and cross into who do not respect our values. One of the solutions I'm proposing today is to start a Limited branch here in London. Join us. Come speak to us. Follow us on social media. And together, let's expose what English women are also going through. Let's defend our civilization together. Thank you, Great Britain. And never forget, love, Christ loves you. Hi, I'm Alice. I'm 23 years old and I am from Nantes, a city in West of France. My city has been governed for the past 10 years by a left mayor and a so-called feminist mayor. Feminism is about making streets after women. That's not feminism. Even less when security is neglected. Assaults and harassments are skyrocketing. Numbers are alarming. Women like me feel forced to take extra precautions when going out. We carry pepper spray, avoiding public transport at night, and sharing location with friends every day. The main only response to tackling insecurity has been to put surveillance cameras. But it only feels like a small bed on a gaping wound. Meanwhile, drug trafficking and drug-related crimes have taken root in the very heart of the city. The prosecutor of Nantes has even stated that many of the offenders who are involved in serious crimes come from Africa, and they show little interest in integrating. This isn't just my story, it's Europe's story. It's our story. This is the reality for every woman in major cities in Europe. Is this really the Europe we want to keep living in and pass on to future generations? We are all here today because we will understand how important it is to stand up against the people in power who are imposing on us immigration and silence.
Wow, so many stories and many testimonies there. And this is the fight for women. It's not just a fight for a country, it's a fight for Britain. And every single man in this crowd should be ready to fight and die for their women, their daughters, and their friends. And this is what true feminism is all about. I want to ask a question. How many people in this crowd support reform? It's gone down since the last time. How many people in the crowd support Tommy Robinson? Well, I am with Nigel. But the reality is, the next speaker is going to show up and out. You can't do both. He should have returned to Tommy Robinson. He lost his position in reform. He should have printed it all. And he should have voted for it. Bring it up, Richard Shaw.
I don't think any of us have ever stood up. I've never seen this many people before. Thank you all for coming out. Thank you. Now, before the election, when I stood for reform, I thought Tommy Robinson was a racist. Because that's what the media told me. And people were asking me during the election, do you support Tommy Robinson?
No, no, it's all racist. It's not a racist. So anyway, I looked into it after the election, and guess what? He's not a racist, obviously. So, I did a video, and I apologised to him, and I put it on Twitter. I never actually thought he'd see it, but he did. And he shared it. And what did Reform do? They kicked me out of the party. Yeah? They removed me from my position as spokesperson and therapist. Because I had the audacity to apologise to Ty. Now, I don't know about you, but I stand up for the truth. And Reform, they said they stood up for the truth. That was what they ran on, that was their whole principle, was that they were doing politics differently. They were going to do politics differently. But they don't. Reform UK are just like the others. They're just a conservative with different branding. So, who are you going to support at the next election? I know who I'm going to support. Who here is going to support you, Kip? Brilliant. That's what I like to hear. Now, later on, now me is going to speak, Victor Connor, you. And I just want to give him my unconditional support and say that what he's planning on doing with you, Kip, and what he wants to do in this country, I agree with you. Completely. It is time to stop the boats. It is time to stop illegal immigration. This is not about race, this is about culture, this is about the survival of our nation. So, I'm going to ask you one more time, who's going to make you kick? Thank you, everybody. Let's do this, let's save our nation. Thank you, Tommy. Pray to our nation.
You try to get a lot of people. to be a
you can't be holding it against the capacity to receive the critical plans
of all the way to the
world. Maybe it's time to show
you the report.
Now, to make it on
démocratique des urnes.
C'est le seul moyen de faire vraiment un changement des choses. Vous êtes courageux et volontaires. Bravo à vous. Nous allons gagner, c'est maintenant ou jamais. Vive le peuple.
So, your iron keeps getting short today. Now, some of you may have seen the video we've done since the Virgin of Thomas in Spain. Now, if you want to watch the video of the Virgin of Thomas, it's the most you can get. Something I want to say is that I know 100% fact that when Tommy hears the amount of people that took it up today, he is going to be so proud of every single one of you. The other thing I want to say, as much as a terrible situation is for Tom Brown sitting inside, I can guarantee you, with how you voted and how you all behaved, he is going to be sitting there with a massive smile on his face. So every single person here, you've got Tommy proud, you've got yourself proud, and more importantly, you've done the country proud. Give yourself a round of applause.
Escorting Tommy back to Britain. He didn't need to tour. He did not need to tour, but he did. He did because he wanted to send a message to that woman there and that shit house there. He broke down in front of me several times, what he wanted to do. But he's not a roadmap, and not should he. He should be the most proudest man, patriot, in this country today. One of the questions.
We are in crisis. We need action.
action now! Wear a form, stumbles, and shies away from the difficult conversations. UKIP will say it as it is.
Referendum on the death penalty!
with your permission, I want to transform this great patriotic movement into real political action and change. Let us rebuild Britain for our children and our children's future. Let us show the liberal establishment that we will not take any more, and we are not their slaves. Let us stand together and break free of the globalist shackles and show them that they dare not make the British people angry. To two-tier care, I say this. You can send your thugs to beat us. You can lock us up. You can martyr us, as you have done our political prisoners. But you will never silence us. No two-tier care, Keir Starmer. You will bend the knee to the British people. If you lend us your vote, and grant UKIP the opportunity, I will lead you, ladies and gentlemen, the new right rises. And as God is my witness, we will take our country back. And when we do, it will be for His glory. In 5 years' time, we vote our way out of this. Thank you.
That you are hooligans,
yes!
Racist, you want me out of this country? Is this right?
No!
Are you saying to your ears? You are wrong. They are not here to throw immigrants out. They don't want those immigrants who are not contributing, who are raping this country. So, wake up. My fellow patriots, my English is not my first language, and it's broken. Broken as this debate right now. But my English cannot be mended. It's not possible. But we can make this debate again with your help. That is doable. Truly. He's fighting for everyone from last 15 years. He's given his youth, his family. He's sacrificing everything. For what? Not for himself, for his country to make it great again. But what this establishment does today, they put him in the prison again. Why? Because they don't want you guys to hear what is the truth. He's telling you something from last 20 years, what this country is going to face if we don't break up. I tell you one thing. I took asylum in this country 28 years ago. I ran from Afghanistan because we were prosecuted, getting killed, getting raped. And this country gave me everything. And today what I saw, every day, both of those rapists coming in here and getting accommodation from the two-tier care, money, iPhone, everything. For what? To rape you. They done that with us, now they will do it with you. They're not letting you know who is coming on the boat. They are the dangerous people, unwitted people. Tommy tries to wake you up. But it's going to be striking balance here. They don't want to let you know what danger is coming next to your door. Tommy steps in the
Then of the lion, even knowing that he will be prosecuted, that he will put everything to happen, but he done it for who? He done it for you. What's he going to get from everything to prison? Nothing. He done everything for people of Great Britain to make Great Britain again. You need to go back to your home. Hey, what's the best of a country? Who is best to run this country? You need those political parties who think about making Britain. They give preference to breaking people first, not me. I came here because I choose to come here. Nobody called me in this country. I choose, many more choose to come here for a better life. I came here, I made my goal. I tried. I got a big community. But for that community today, I'm a traitor. They call me a traitor. I am not a traitor. This is my country, and I have to give back to this country. I am loyal to this country. So every immigrant should be loyal to this country. If they want to live in the community, go fucking back! If you are in this country, your loyalty will stay with this country. This country gave us a lot. And it's time for us immigrants to pay back. Good evening, Britain, and once more, Tommy. Tommy Robinson, please say for me.
Declaring a blessing over you. Before I do that, if anybody is interested in an eyewitness account of Jesus, let the right of the site here and read. There will be people with Gospels of John they can actually give to you if you want to avail yourself of the good news of Jesus. Let me declare a blessing over you. Go forth in peace. Go into the world and be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Support the weak. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Show love to anyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of His might. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you, remain with you, and with those whom you love, now and evermore. Amen.
Right now is really a battle between good and evil that we're facing in our country. And we know that this side we're on is certainly the side of good. Now when Tommy spoke to us about today's event, there was one song that he specially requested. And if we
Listen to the lyrics of this song as we sing it. It's more relevant than ever. You can even hear the lyrics applying to Tommy right now in this situation. And we just want to honor and respect every service man and woman that's here today. We can clap our hands for our service man and woman in here today. This song is 100 years old, but it's as relevant today as it ever has to be. It's called I Vow Thee to My Country.
Written by a great British poet called Sir William Blake.
And this song is more relevant now than ever before. And as we see it today, we see it as a battle cry. That Jerusalem was built in this great land here. And right now it's our duty, everyone that's here today, to rebuild Jerusalem in this land. We are great because we were built on a solid foundation. And that solid foundation was Jesus Christ. It was Christianity. And we can never move away from it. We need to rebuild Jerusalem now. We need to stand on that solid rock that is Christianity. This is our time and our moment. Let's put our flags in the air with our fire.
And there goes me in ancient time, walk on England's mountains green, and watch the holy Lamb of God on England's pleasant pastures see, and let the countenance survive. Shine forth upon our clouded hills, and watch Jerusalem build in here. Among those that say,
I'm sorry. Check, check.
Hey, I'm too short for that one anyway.
Wow! Powerful! So this is the last words from me. This is where I dish out some thank yous. Thank you to everyone that's organised this today. Thank you to the police that are standing behind us, keeping us safe from Antifa. Thank you to all the singers and the speakers. Thank you for Tommy. Thank you to Tommy. Thank you, Tommy. Yes, get on the line. All of you need to know here. Put all of you together in harmony. Yes, he has. And then thank you, Tommy. And thank you for coming. I just want to ask one thing. Please, for the love of God, get home to your families safe and be peaceful on your return. London, I fucking love you! Thank you! And now it's time for the lovely dancers to see us off. I'll see you on the outside. I'm going to go to the hospital.
Oh, have to fight.
Then I'm going to think that that's a show over, but it's not. Tell me what's the law. We said to Tommy, if you go to prison, we're going to play this song as a tribute to you. Play, play, let's press the song for Tommy Robinson and our clothes.
So have you ever heard of a music video before? Hold on, can you cut us? So we're going to close, but this is going to be the footage we're going to use this as an official music video, so you guys are all going to be in it, so I need you to get as involved as you possibly can. So I'm just going to play the pantomime music, and we're going to all celebrate Tommy with this song right now, and we're going to use it to make a video, okay? Everybody good? Yeah. Let's go, baby.
To było wspaniałe zgromadzenie, właśnie się skończyło. Dostałem książkę. Pokażę tytuł. Nie wiem, o czym jest. The Great Controversy. Will two former rival unite?
I'd like to say hello to my friend Nicky.
Oh, yeah.
Nicky, can you see it?
Well, I doubt it because my channel is so small, but you. You're free to say hello to whoever you like.
Hi, everybody. Probably the wrong one, but yeah, she'll go and find it.
Oh,
thank
yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Have a good day. Więc jak widzicie, skończyło się. Było naprawdę przyjemnie. Było bardzo dużo patriotów, ludzi różnej maści. No i wszyscy idą powoli do domu. Ja też będę zmierzał do domu, ale to był wspaniały dzień. Dam linki w opisach do filmu, który tutaj został puszczony. W trakcie. Nie chciałem tego filmować, bo uznałem, że lepsza jakość, tak jak mówiłem wcześniej, będzie, jeśli zrobimy to troszkę inaczej. Po prostu przez link. Dobra, dziękuję wam za oglądanie. Trzymajcie się, wspierajcie się, bo w całej Europie i na całym świecie dzieje się to samo lewactwo, to sama degeneracja naszego społeczeństwa. A tego nie chcemy. Chcemy po prostu żyć. Żyć w spokoju. Nikomu nie zawadzać, ale żeby też nikt nie zawadzał nam. To o to chodzi. Tutaj ci wszyscy ludzie, którzy tutaj przyszli, naprawdę byli spokojni, naprawdę byli bardzo dobrzy, mile się zachowywali. Przepraszam za kadrowanie, ale ciężko mi trochę utrzymać stick już po kilku godzinach. No, ale było wspaniale. Dobra, to do zobaczyska. Dzielcie się tym materiałem. Bym był bardzo szczęśliwy, jakby troszkę więcej osób obejrzało, żeby troszkę więcej nas, Polaków w Anglii też zaczęła interesować ta sprawa. Bo to, co się dzieje tutaj, przychodzi właśnie do Polski. To, co się dzieje tutaj, już jest w całej Europie, jest w Stanach Zjednoczonych. Jest bardzo źle. Dlatego ludzie już... To nie to, że ludzie tego wcześniej nie widzieli. Duża część osób widziała, ale to jest w pewnym punkt taki jakby, którym już mają dość, prawda? Dobra, znowu się rozgoduję, a to bez sensu. Trzymajcie się, kochani. Niech wam wszystko się wiedzie i do zobaczenia w następnych filmach. Pozdrawiam z Londynu.